Don't forget to subscribe and turn the notifications. We upload daily, and check the source of this video to view all the images and videos if there was any. Siobhan McLaughli, 46, was refused the benefit after her partner John Adams died from cancer. Pictured, arriving for a press conference at Law Society House, Belfast, following the Supreme Court ruling in her favour. An unmarried mother has won her legal battle over access to widowed parents' allowance after Supreme Court justices ruled that denying her the benefit is unlawful. Siobhan McLaughli, 46, was refused the benefit after her partner John Adams died from cancer in January 2014 because the couple, who had four children and were together for 23 years, were not married or in a civil partnership. She initially won a case after claiming unlawful discrimination based on her marital status, but that ruling was later overturned by the Court of Appeal. But, by a majority of 4 justices to 1, the Supreme Court ruled on Thursday that the current law on the allowance is incompatible with human rights legislation. Speaking at a press conference after her victory today, Ms. McLaughli described the ordeal as an emotional rollercoaster. She said, "I have cried and beamed with joy and cried more. Surreal, but we're really happy. For us, it was always a case that this was wrong and it was to fight that injustice, so if this is what has to be done, this is what has to be done. There was not a thought process of, this is hard, let's not do it, because that would have been just a cop-out. How then do you show your children that you give up at the first hurdle?" Unmarried mother Siobhan McLaughli speaks to the press gathered in Belfast today. Ms. McLaughli, 46, was refused the benefit after her partner John Adams, pictured with their children, died from cancer in January 2014 because the couple, who had 4 children and were together for 23 years, were not married or in a civil partnership. She told Sky News later today, "I did not realize things took so long in law, but it was sure worth the wait. What is the widowed parents allowance and who can claim it? You may get widowed parents allowance, WPA, if all the following apply: your husband, wife or civil partner died before the 6th of April 2017, you're under state pension age, you're entitled to child benefit for at least one child and your late husband, wife or civil partner was their parent, your late husband, wife or civil partner paid national insurance contributions, or they died as a result of an industrial accident or disease. You may also claim WPA if you're pregnant and your husband has died, or you're pregnant after fertility treatment and your civil partner has died. At the moment, the government guidelines state that you cannot claim WPA if you were divorced from your husband, wife or civil partner when they died, remarry or are living with another person as if you're married to them or as if you've formed a civil partnership, were over state pension age when you were widowed or became a surviving civil partner. You may be able to get extra state pension. Are in prison. The rules may now change following Ms. McLaughlin's victory in court. However, Lady Hale said not every case where an unmarried parent is denied the allowance after the death of their partner will be unlawful. The court also said it is up to the government to decide whether or how to change the law. Ms. McLaughli revealed that she chose not to marry because her partner John was widowed when she met him. Before his previous wife died, he promised that he would not remarry. She said, "He didn't realize that he would meet me a few years later and that we would spend 23 years together and raise 4 children. We've just got on with life," she told Sky News. "Your life changes after you lose a loved one. We adjust, the children have got older, our lives changed, we're not the same people we were 4 years ago. I would like to think we're better for it. We have always been a close-knit unit and we're closer." She admitted that the benefits system can be a bit of a minefield, but that the ruling was not about the money but to ensure that justice prevailed. Giving the lead judgment, the court's president Lady Hale said, "The allowance exists because of the responsibilities of the deceased and the survivor towards their children. Those responsibilities are the same whether or not they are married to or in a civil partnership with one another. The purpose of the allowance is to diminish the financial loss caused to families with children by the death of a parent. That loss is the same whether or not the parents are married or in a civil partnership with one another." The rules may now change following Ms. McLaughlin's victory in court. However, Lady Hale said not every case where an unmarried parent is denied the allowance after the death of their partner will be unlawful. The court also said it is up to the government to decide whether or how to change the law. A Department for Work and Pensions spokesman said, "We will consider the court's ruling carefully. Widowed parents' allowance was a contributory benefit and it has always been the case that inheritable benefits derived from another person's contributions should be based on the concept of legal marriage or civil partnership. This ruling doesn't change the current eligibility rules for receiving bereavement benefits, which are paid only to people who are married or in a civil partnership. Siobhan McLaughlin is pictured with her children Billy and Rebecca Adams. She has finally won her legal battle over access to widowed parents' allowance after Supreme Court justices ruled that denying her the benefit is unlawful. Ms. McLaughlin, a special needs classroom assistant from Armoy, Coantrum, was with her partner John Adams, a groundsman, for 23 years and they had four children, Rebecca, 15, Billy, 16, Lisa, 21, and Stuart, 23. Following Mr. Adams's death, Ms. McLaughlin had to take on an evening job after being refused widowed parents' allowance by the Northern Ireland Department for Communities. The Supreme Court heard her application for a judicial review back in April this year. Prior to the hearing in April, she said, "It is heartbreaking to even contemplate the difference this could have made. It might have just made life slightly easier. It might have meant that I could have been at home every night to prepare supper as I had been when John was here. But, because I had to go back to work, I am no longer there, so not only did they lose their dad, they also lost me and that stability. But, I have to provide for them, to pay the rent for the house and you have to go on and that's hard," she added. "I get that the benefit is called a widowed parent's allowance and that the child element is branched within that. I get that I am not allowed to class myself as a widow. It was a family unit. The children have John's surname, his name on their birth certificates." Her lawyer, Frank O'Donoghue QC, asked the court in April, "Is there a defensive aspect to this legislation, holding up Ms. McLaughlin as an example to what might happen to you if you don't get married?" Mr. O'Donoghue said Ms. McLaughlin should be treated equally to a married couple with children after the death of the breadwinner. "The court should require the state, as we prepare to enter the third decade of the 21st century, to justify this obvious difference in treatment, beyond the rather simplistic and rigid explanation that one widow was married and the other was not," he said. As a bare minimum, entitlement to widowed parents' allowance on the part of cohabiting unmarried parents and children is required. Mr. O'Donoghue said the benefit is not for the married couple but for the survivor and children and claimed there is no evidence proving current restrictions promote marriage. Speaking outside court after the April hearing in the Supreme Court, which sat in Northern Ireland for the first time, Ms. McLaughlin thanked supporters attending with two of her children. She said, "This case was never about me. I would love to be recognized as a widow, but I accept in the eyes of the law and the government that I am not. What I wasn't prepared to accept was how the government viewed my children, how they could treat my grieving, bereaved children as insignificant. I am such a private person, but to sit and accept that this is how it has made me say, no, this is wrong. I want to look my children in the eye and say it is the government at fault here, not you, and because of this I have tried to rectify this for you."